So this is one of the motors that controls the F-35 duct, the rotation of it to transition from hover mode to airplane mode. So what we have here is a little electric motor with a planetary gear. Planetary gears to transfer the rotational speed, to speed it up to, I think this one is 1 to 150 ratio. So that means that this one rotates 150 times faster than the gear. And then here at the back, we see a little encoder that we've soldered onto the motor. It's an encoder that is a magnetic encoder. It's a pair kit that you can buy online. Basically what you see here is you see a little printed circuit board, and on here this little circular thing is actually connected to the shaft of the little motor that rotates while the motor rotates. And this little wheelie thingy that is actually a magnet that spins over some sensors that we have there, and every time it rotates this little printed circuit board counts basically the magnet going over the little sensor, and with that we can count how many revolutions the motor does, so that we can do accurate positioning on the of the F-35 duct. So now I'm gonna pre-tin the wires so that I can solder them better on the board, or quicker. So I'm just gonna put a little drop on there. Don't put too much, never put too much. So just a little bit, and then they're pre-tinned, and then they can be easily soldered onto the circuit board. Okay, so what we did is we had some troubles programming the printed circuit board, but after debugging some stuff there, we solved the solution, and then we did a calibration. So the calibration, what that means is that the computer in there, it needs to find out what the maximum and minimum limits are for the motor to move, both on this area here and from here to here. And then as soon as we've calibrated, it will store its calibration, and it's able to move. And that will act completely as if it is like a servo. Okay, so these limit switches here, they are actually not supposed to be hit. They are really to prevent it from running off the track. So if for example I were to touch it, see, it would completely stop movement in one direction, but it would still allow movement in the other direction. So they're basically a safeguard that we've made in so that it cannot run off the track. Okay, so the computer that we have here that controls all this F-35 duct movement is basically a Arduino Mini. We've made a printed circuit board that we can put an Arduino Mini on, and some motor controller drivers that we have there, and a pin layout and some other little bips and bobs. But Yeah, that's about it. It's actually relatively simple, but with this setup you can control it as if it's one servo motor instead of two motors with encoders, with limit switches, etc, etc. Okay, so the code is actually relatively simple. We've put a lot of the stuff in libraries that we use that are also available for other Arduino projects. So if you look at a setup, which basically run at the beginning when it powers up, it checks whether it needs a calibration. Then it initializes all the components, all the libraries, wakes up the motors, and then if a calibration is needed, then it will do the calibration, and as soon as the entire setup procedure has been done, it will continuously loop. It will execute the processor, which will run the PID control loops to make sure that the positioning of the motors goes correct, and it will continuously check for the limit switches, whether they've been triggered or not. So the next step is for Joel to do the cable management. I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure to leave a like. If you really enjoyed it and also like videos like these, make sure you subscribe and don't miss one. Next you'll see Joel basically testing some more, building a lift engine for the F-35, and a lot of awesome stuff.